Great job, Ace. We have earned another chance to show what we can do. This time with Emon.
Alright, Ace. Thanks to that little scrap you and Aaron got yourselves into with the Varaxo, Uncle Anton wants me to make sure you know how to stay alive when the shooting starts. Your instincts served you well at Harlequin Station. It's evident you've learned something useful from all those space combat sims you're always playing. But now, it's for real. And you can't rely on just instincts and sim experiences. I guess the most important thing to remember is that a YT-1300 isn't a starfighter. For transport, it is fast, light, and maneuverable, but you wouldn't want to take on an Imperial TIE fighter in it. The fact of the matter is, you're better off avoiding trouble in the first place, rather than trying to fight your way out after you've gotten into it. I'm going to run you through some simple targeting exercises, then we'll fly off to an old debris field. It'll be easier than shooting Minox off a power cable. I'll program some drones to liven things up a bit.
We will fly the Sabra again, with yours truly as pilot, and you occupying the gun turret. Emon will be flying the Andrasta, his personally customized CORT Systems Engineering Fire Spray class patrol craft. We will use drones to help you familiarize yourself with the targeting and sensor systems, and the associated displays available in the gun turret. As soon as you're ready, Emon will lead the way to a debris field, where you can practice your gunnery skills. This is going to be great! We will fly the Sabra again, with yours truly as...
Try not to hit anything in your way, I...
Sir, my flight record is quite unblemished.
I know, I'm just rousing you a little. Hope you're enjoying the ride in the gunner's turret, little brother. Alright, MK. Park your ship above that rendezvous buoy. I'm gonna deploy a drone for Ace to track.
Emon will drop off a few drones while he explains.
Target the drone, then examine the CMD and sensor displays. The CMD identifies the target and displays critical target data. The sensor displays allow you to track all nearby objects. Just remember, the bracketed dot is what you have targeted. The colors identify friend from foe, neutral and unknown. Purple is family, blue is neutral, presumed friendly. Red designates an Imperial vessel, and green is a rebel craft. Gold is any other aggressor or unknown that is presumed hostile. So what do you say, you and I just get straight to the shooting?
Go ahead and shoot all the drones.
Hmm. No doubt you figured it out. Blast everything in sight. Target the nearest piece of junk and destroy it. Okay, MG. Just keep her steady through the junkyard.
Yes, sir. Permission to take evasive maneuvers if necessary?
Denied. It's up to your gunner to blast anything threatening.
Splendid! I have total confidence in his ability.
Wonderful. Now if you pipe down, we'll proceed. Hey, let's celebrate. I'll buy you a drink at Dunari's Casino.
Dunari's Casino? That place has a colorful reputation.
Follow me, MK. You have the coordinates. Hey, does that pursuer look familiar?
Hey! Enemy in range!
Yes, we chased that ship away from Harlequin Station.
Yeah, and they shot at you, didn't they? Let's go show them what we think of that. Andrasta, you just worn out your welcome. Ceasefire at once. Settle your disputes elsewhere. Acknowledge. Just leave it.
I'm under attack.
Sorry, little brother. We'll get that drink some other time.
Who else won't stop?
All right. That wasn't too shabby. I guess you won't be so helpless out in the real world after all.
Not too shabby. You've demonstrated pretty decent gunnery skills in the good old YT-1300. I guess we can trust you with some of the riskier jobs that sometimes come our way. You might actually be useful the next time some stinking group of pirates tries to jump one of our ships.